On November 25th, 2018, U.S. agents fired tear gas at migrants on the Tijuana-San Diego border. The tear gas was manufactured by the Safariland Group, owned by Warren B. Canders, the vice chair of the Board of Trustees of the Whitney Museum of American Art, which commissioned this work. In response, Forensic Architecture is training a machine learning classifier to search for images of tear gas grenades manufactured by the Safariland Group. We took as our test case the Triple Chaser tear gas grenade manufactured by Defense Technology, a subsidiary of Safariland. Computer vision using machine learning begins by training a classifier to recognize objects in images. Bounding boxes and masks tell the classifier where in the image the tear gas grenade exists. This process usually requires a training set of thousands of images, but we were only able to identify fewer than 100 images of the Triple Chaser online. So, we set out to create a synthetic training set. We reached out to activists to find and photograph Triple Chaser grenades. An insurance claims adjuster named Mikol sent us this video from Tijuana. An artist, Emily Jassir, sent us this from her Bethlehem Art and Research Center, probably the most tear gassed artist residency in the world. From these, we created a digital model according to the specifications in the product catalog. We recreated all the permutations of Triple Chaser branding around the world. And using this model, we generated thousands of images. We set the model against bold patterned backgrounds to ensure that the classifier learns to identify the grenades, rather than the common elements of the backgrounds in which they often appear. We used colored masks to tell the classifier where the grenades are in the image. We also placed the model in photorealistic environments. In 2016, Warren B. Canders gave $2.5 million to the Aspen Music Festival. In thanks, the festival renamed the Sunday concert series in his honor, the inaugural evening of which began with a performance of the Four Last Songs by Richard Strauss. Now that we've created a synthetic data set, we train the machine learning algorithm to recognize Safariland Triple Chaser tear gas grenades. These images are sampled from our synthetic training data set. We also trained the classifier to recognize what is not a Triple Chaser grenade.
Oh,
and we train it to recognize the triple chaser in simulated real-world environments. Safariland's safety guidance provides the following information to doctors. Severe allergic skin reaction, bronchial spasms, and anaphylactic shock are possible. Irritant to eyes. Irritant to skin and mucous membranes. Breathing difficulty. Disorientation. Danger. Danger of blast or crush type injuries. Danger of pulmonary edema. Danger of disturbed cardiac rhythm. Danger of convulsion. Danger of impaired breathing. Danger of cerebral edema. Several members of our team have experienced the effects of tear gas. One was amongst the Turkish citizens who protested in Gezi Park in 2013. During the nationwide protests that followed, Turkish police fired 130,000 tear gas grenades. While tear gas is banned from use in war, governments use it to suppress the right of civilians to collectively protest in public space. Safariland sells tear gas grenades around the world. We have found evidence of its use against civilians in the US, Turkey, Peru, Iraq, Israel, Palestine, Yemen, Bahrain, Tunisia, Guyana, Venezuela, Egypt, and Canada. After we train our classifier on synthetic images, we will deploy it to search for real ones, leveraging tags and keywords. The system returns a percentage for each image, indicating its confidence that the highlighted pixels signify a triple chaser tear gas grenade manufactured by the Safariland Group. In 2017, the Claris Corporation, of which Kanders is executive chairman, purchased the U.S. manufacturer Sierra Bullets for $79 million. As part of our investigation, we discovered that Sierra's open-tip Match King bullets, seen here, are used by Israeli Military Industries, or IMI, the preferred supplier of ammunition to the Israeli army. We worked with activists to gather cartridges on the Israeli side of the Gaza border. What they found shows that the Israeli army fired IMI ammunition into occupied Gaza. Between March and December 2018, Israeli snipers killed 154 civilian protesters on the Palestinian side of this border fence, including 35 children. More than 6,000 were wounded. A member of our team was at the protests in Gaza and gathered this footage with local filmmakers. The UN concluded that the actions of Israeli soldiers during that time may constitute war crimes or crimes against humanity. We contacted Sierra to ask if their bullets are used by the Israeli army.
Are you still there with me, sir?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. As far as how our product is being used by other companies, I've told that it's confidential and it's not information that I can give out.
We shared our findings with the European Center for Constitutional and Human Rights, who served Sierra Bullets with legal notice, warning that the exports of their bullets to Israel may be aiding and abetting war crimes.